فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
But we'll just listen to it. But all of this is a summary of what just happened. Okay.
وأما الحذف فيكون علامة للجزم في الفعل المضارع المفعول الأخير وفي الأفعال التي رفعها بثبات النون. المعربات قسمان: قسم يعرب بالحركات وقسم يعرب بالحروف. الذي يعرب بالحركات أربعة أنواع: الاسم المفرد وجمع التكسير وجمع المؤنث السالم والفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. وكلنا
Your voice a bit weak. So do I. لا إله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكلها ترفع بالضمة وتنصب بالفتحة وتخفض بالكسرة وتجزم بالسكون. وخرج عن ذلك ثلاثة أشياء: جمع المؤنث السالم ينصب بالكسرة، والاسم الذي لا ينصرف يخفض بالفتحة، والفعل المضارع المعتل الآخر يجزم بحذف الآخر. والذي يعرف بالحروف أربعة أنواع: التثنية وجمع المذكر السالم، والأسماء الخمسة، والأفعال الخمسة وهي يفعلان وتفعلان ويفعلون وتفعلون وتفعلين. فأما التثنية فترفع بالألف وتنصب وتخفض بالياء، وأما جمع المذكر السالم فيرفع بالواو وينصب ويخفض بالياء، وأما الأسماء الخمسة فترفع بالواو وتنصب بالألف وتخفض بالياء، وأما الأفعال الخمسة فترفع بالنون وتنصب وتجزم بحذفها. باب الأفعال. الأفعال ثلاثة: ماض ومضارع وأمر.
Now the author رحمه الله كرر هاي كرر.
نحو ضرب ويضرب واضرب.
Now the author is taking us to the other chapter. So we've now walillahi alhamdu wal minnah, praises to Allah. We've done Bab al-I'rab. We've also done Bab al-Ma'rifati alamat al-I'rab. We've now are going into the third chapter for today, which is Bab al-Af'al. We've got this chapter and the next chapter to do, and we've accomplished today's session, which is Bab al-Af'al and Bab al-Marfu'at al-Asma. If we do that, we're very good. Okay? The author now goes into Aqsam al-Af'al and its ahkam, its rulings. So what are the types of verbs? Something we already took. What did we say? Al-af'alu thalathatun. It's three. Madin wa mudari'un wa amrun. Those are the three. So the af'al are categorized into how many? Three. Madi, which is what? Past. Madi is always what? Mabniun ala al-fath. Mabni ala al-fath. Are you with me, brothers? The madi is what? Mabniun ala al-fath. It's mabni with what? Fath. The mudari' is what? It is mu'rab and it is also mabni. It's mu'rab with what? Al-raf'u, wal-nasbu, wal-jazmu. And it is mabni when two things enter it. So it's mabni with two things, sorry. Mabni ala al-sukun and it's mabni ala al-fath. And it only becomes mabni when two things happen, when two things enter it. Nunu al-tawkid and nunu niswa. If nunu al-tawkid, which is the nun of emphasis, enters it, or the nun of feminine enters it, the fi'l mudari' moves from being i'mu'rab and it becomes mabni. And we haven't studied mabni at all. This book does not talk about mabni. So that's why لم أتطرق إليه. I didn't start speaking about it. The Amr, on the other hand, is always mabni, and it is mabni على الجزم. It is mabni جزم, and it becomes it's mabni على ما يجزم به مضارعه. The فعل مضارع, whatever made it مجزوم. What was the فعل مضارع مجزوم on? سكون and what? حذف, right? So is the فعل أمر. But it's مبني على السكون. And it is مبني على الحذف. صح؟ That's why some of the scholars only believe. Like the scholars from Basra, the Basriyun, they only believe that the أفعال are two types. ماضي المضارع خلاص أمر is under the مضارع كوفيون هو بليد three times are you with me it's the call of the جمهور as well now the author is going to mention what I've just said to you right now that's what he's going to say to you are you So he gives you an example of each one. Daraba is ماضي. يضرب is مضارع. واضرب is فعل أمر. هيا.
فالماضي مفتوح لآخر أبدا. والأمر مجزوم أبدا. والمضارع ما كان في أوله إحدى الزوائد الأربعة. يجمعها قوله.
التي.
ال.
إذا زيادة خايف هذا.
يجمعها قوله أنيت. وهو مرفوع أبدا حتى يدخل عليه ناصب أو جازم.
Now the author mentions. That the ماضي is always what? مفتوح الآخر أبدا. He means it's مبني على الفتح always. Okay? والأمر مجزوم أبدا. And also, the فعل أمر is always مبني على الجزم. أما it is على ما يجزم به مضارعه. The مضارع on the other hand, as we said, it's مرفوع, منصوب, and it's مجزوم. صح? But all of that is when it's what? When it's what? When it's مرفوع. So when it's معرب, Okay, pay attention to this. The أصل of فعل مضارع is, the default position of فعل مضارع is when it's معرب. Forget when it's مبني. We don't care about مبني now. When it is معرب, the أصل of the فعل مضارع is that you place a رفع on it. It's مرفوع. That's the أصل. The only time it moves from that position is when those words go before it. If أدوات النصب goes before it, it diverts it from being مرفوع. If أدوات الجزم goes before it, it also removes it from being مرفوع. Are you with me? So that's why he says, وهو مرفوع أبدا. It's always مرفوع. حتى يدخل عليه ناصب. Until أدوات النصب go before it. وراء أدوات النصب, we're going to take them soon, inshallah. أو جازم, أو أدوات الجزم goes before it. If أدوات الجزم goes before the فعل مضارع, it makes it what? It makes it, it changes it. So it becomes mansub or it becomes majzoom. Are you with me? Other than that, if I write the word yaf'al on the word, it's yaf'al, right? Okay? But if lam or len or something like that goes before it, it changes it. Okay? Also, he tells you another thing, which is how can I identify that this is a fi'il mudari? How can I know fi'il mudari? The way that you know a fi'il mudari is that he said anaytu. Anaytu are what goes before it. Alif, noon, ya, and Ta. If any of those four go before it, what does it become? It's a fi'il mudari. Daraba, 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 dad, ra, ba, daraba. What's that? Madi. How do you know it's a madi? Because I can't see an alif before it, nor can I see a noon before it. Neither can I, or can I see a, what do you call it, a ya or a ta. Any, I can't see any of those before it. Now you want to make a mudari. What are you going to say? Daraba. How are you going to say it? Adribu, nadribu, yadribu, tadribu. Are you with me? Alif went before it, noon went before it, ya went before it, ta went before it. What does it become? Fi'il mudari. That's called a zawa'id al-arba'a. What does zawa'id mean? Additional. The four additional letters. Additional what? It's trying to tell you that the madi is the original essence of the word. The madi is daraba is the original default position. The mudari comes and it adds onto the madi that's already there in the beginning of it. Alif, noon, ya, and ta. Does that make sense? Very good. Yeah.
والنواصب عشرة هي أن ولم وإذ وكيف ولام كيف ولام جثور وحتى والجواب بالفاء والواو والواو
Now the author رحمه الله he is going into and is speaking about نواصب الفعل المضارع Before we go into the نواصب let's quickly go back to something which is let's go back to the ماضي And the مضارع and the أمر. Let's have a bit of more understanding. Let's go a bit deep. What's the ماضي? What did I say? It's always what? It's مبني على الفتح. And it's in two ways that it's مبني على الفتح. Two ways. The first one is ظاهر, apparent. You can see it. Okay, it's ظاهر. Such as the word نصارى, ضرب, فتح, قتل, ضحك. Those are apparent. Okay? That's the ماضي we're talking about here, right? All of those are مبني على الفتح, and it's apparent. You can see it. The second is مقدم. It's implicit. You can't really see it now. It's implicit. It's implicit. And it comes in three ways. The first one is a ta'adhur. It's called ta'adhur. The third one is ta'adhur. Example of it is rama. The second one is al-munasabah. Dhahabu. What happened to the ba? It was meant to, it was dhahaba. Now you're saying dhahabu. What happened? It changed. This is called munasabah. I'll speak about it. And the third one is daf'u al-karaha. Daf'u al-karaha. What is that? Fahim. Him. Him. What happened to the mim? You place a sukun on it. Fahim tu. Fahim tu. What happened to the mim? You place a sukun there. It wasn't meant to be fahima. Are you with me? So it's always mabni ala al-fath. But the way that the fath shows is two ways. This view, like I'm telling you, is view of some of the nuhat, some of the grammarians who say this. Others would have said, and if you guys like the idea, you can take that if you wish to. They would have said, no, that the fi'l madi is not always mabni ala al-fath. It's not always the case. It's mabni ala al-fath sometimes. It's sometimes mabni ala al-dham. And sometimes it's mabni ala al-sukun. So when you saw ذهبوا, they say to you here, it's مبني على الضم. So you see a ضم there? Say مبني على الضم. فهمتوا. You can see سكون there, right? They say مبني على السكون.
Ah. Would it depend on the wasn?
Of the word, no. In what way do you mean? How would it?
Like the ثلاثي. It goes to self.
Yeah.
فعل, فعل.
So yeah, so the word, if it's a three letter of a word, right, like for example, fahima, it comes from the word fa'ila, and fa'ula, and fa'ala. When it's a thulathi letter, as Ibn Malik says in Islamiyya, bifa'ala lal fi'lu, ذو التجريد أو فعلا يأتي ومكسور عين أو فعلا وضم من فعل الزم في المضارع وافتح موضع الكسر في المبني من فعلا. وَجَانِ فِيهِ مِنْ إِحْسِنْ مَعْ وَغِيرْتَ وَحِيرْتَ الْعِمْتَ أَوْلِهِيَ بِسْوَهِلَى فَعَلَ فَعِلَ فَعُلَى is why it comes in. That hasn't got anything to do with the madi here right now. It does have when we convert it to a mudari'. But when we're talking about that grammar, we're more focused on the what? The last letter. We're not concerned about the middle letter. The sarf only deals with the middle letter because da ra ba. The ra is here's fatha. Da hi ka is also a madi, but it's the ha here has got kasra. Are you with me? That's sarf. Why is it like that sarf? As for grammar, we don't really care about the middle changing or not. All we care about is the last letter. What's happening here? So what they are saying is the habu, the ba that we knew. That should have had a fatha on it. Yeah. You now see it with a dhamm. So for us, it's mabniun ala dhamm. We don't care. And I like that madhab. The reason why I like it, first of all, it's easier for the student. Why do you have to keep bringing it back to a fatha? Why? Just what you see is what it is. That's easier. And also, other scholars like Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid and Ibn Aqil and others, they argue, why do you have to keep bringing it back to fatha? Is there a reason? Is it the asal? Is it what? Rather, bida mabni, the asal is jazm. If you're actually going to bring back something to something, then bring it back to jazm. Why do you have to always bring it back to fatha? What's forcing you to bring it back to fatha? Does that make sense? But here, the qawl that we're going to take here right now, because the author already said this, he said that. The madi is always mabni, maftuh, right? So here, if we take that opinion, it becomes three, it becomes two. It's ظاهر, which is like نصارى, فتح, قتل, or not. That's ظاهر, you can see it. And these three times you can't see it, but he's trying to say that it's مبني على الفتح, but you just can't see it. It's implicit. التعذر means that the word excuses you and says, look, just give me excuse, man, I can't do this. So it means that it won't show in any way form or shape. That's what ta'addur means. Al-munasaba means that it's only taken the dhamm because of the word that came after. It sounds like a dhamm, which is what? The waw. The waw, what's the sign of the waw? And what is a dhamma? Right? So bimad al-munasabah is mudkud, mujawara, the neighbors. And this is an example of whoever you hang around is what you become, right? Yeah. Are you with me, brothers? If you hang around with somebody, they can affect you. You look at the word. Bad friends will affect you. Look at the words being affected here by the waw. Because imagine you had to say, dhahabaw. Would that be hard? It would be hard to say it, right? Are you with me? Just like it would be hard if you wanted to go to the masjid and hang around with drug dealers. Sah? If you want to pray in the masjid, the 5 daily prayers and stuff like that, you hang around with drug dealers, it just contradicts each other. It can't be done. The third which is muqaddar, is daf'ul karaha. Karaha means what? Karaha, again, it means is disliked. It is, what's disliked? Tawali arba'u harakati mutawaliya is what's disliked. 4 haraka connecting with each other one time. Fahamata. You can say it, it's karaha. The Arabic language that works towards yusr, ease. So look, fahim, relax, fahim. How easy. You're stopping and then you're carrying on. Karaha here is that what's disliked is the carrying on all of it as harakat. Those are the 3, hey? Then the second one is the fi'l abar. The fi'l abar, as we said before, is mabniun ala sukun, and it has zahir and it has muqaddar. For example, idrib, the sukun is seen. Are you there? If hamanna is muqaddar. But it's what? Mabniun ala sukun. Are you there, brothers? Also hadf, and it's 2 types. حذف العلة when you say اسعى strive or حذف النون when it's أفعال الخمسة افهما understand. We already spoke about the مضارع. The author already spoke about the مضارع. We mentioned it. هيا
هو الجواز من 18 وهي لم ولما وألم وألما ولام والأمر والدعاء
ولا مرفوع. How many times can it remove from being مرفوع? 2. Due to what? If أدوات النصب or أدوات الجزم go before it. Are you with me, brothers? Does that make sense? So now the question is what are the أدوات النصب? The أدوات النصب, the author mentions here 10. These 10, if they go before the فعل مضارع, they will force the فعل مضارع to be made what? فتحة. نصب, منصوب. Okay, for example, تَلْعَبُ is what you say before, right? Right? Put أَن before it. أَن تَلْعَبَ, you say. It was تَلْعَبُ. أَن went before it, it becomes تَلْعَبَ because it's from the أدواتُ. It's called the أدواتُ النَّصْبِ. The أدواتُ النَّصْبِ are 2 types. The first one is, they're called adawat nasb fi'l al-mudari' bi nafsiha, it does it itself. And it's 4 of those. The author mentioned 10. 4 of those 10, they make the fi'l mudari' mansub itself. And it's from the 4 is an, lam, idan, and k. The first 4 that he mentions are all called نواصب الفعل المضارع بنفسها. It does it itself. It does it what? itself. And there how many? وَهُوَ أَرْبَعَةٌ and it's four. أَنْ وَلَنْ وَإِذَنْ وَكَيْنْ. The أَنْ here, brothers, is مَزْدَرِيَّة. مَزْدَرِيَّة means a verb or noun. Anything that comes after it can be turned into a مَزْدَر, a verb or noun. So example, you say عَجِبْتُ مِنْ أَنْ تَلْعَبَ. أي عَجِبْتُ, I am fascinated. مِنْ أَنْ تَلْعَبَ, I am fascinated from you to play. A min lu'bika. I brought mazdar out of it. I can actually get rid of the an and turn the whole word into a mazdar. Emerge it with it. Are you with me, brothers? That's what it means, that the an can turn the word into a mazdar. That I can actually drop the an and I can drop the fi'l mudari that it brought and turn it into a mazdar. Does that make sense? The an is mazdariya. Mazdariya means verbal noun. So you say, sorry, what did I say? عَجِبْتُ بِاللَّعِبَكَ. That's one. أَمَا بِاللُّعْبِكَ. Both you can say. Huh? How, what happened? Yeah, I can say it became a مَزْدَر. صح, brothers? Are you with me? Yeah? The second one is إِلَّن. لَن here is... Sad, I pulled it. I cut him out. Check. The len, it negates. It's a negator. It negates. Pay attention. What was the mudari'? What does it show? Mudari' is a what? Is it a past tense, present tense, or future? Present tense. When len enters it, it becomes what? فَتَسِيرُ مُسْتَقْبَلًا. It becomes future. وَتُسَيِّرُ مَعْنَاهُ مُسْتَقْبَلًا. It makes its meaning become future. The word, the fi'l mudari' here is a future meaning now. For example, you would say لَن تَقْرَأَ, you're not going to read in the future. ما أخلدوتيد, you're not going to read. We're talking about what? The future. So there are words that can enter the فعل مضارع that force it to become past tense. And there are things that can enter that can make it what? Future. Future, yeah? That's how we Somalis say it. Are you with me, brothers? And three is إذن. The author mentioned the third one, which is إذن. And we're still in نواصب الفعل المضارع بنفسها. إذن here. Are you with me, brothers? إذن, it's a response to a question, a point that was put before, or it's a جواب لما قبلها وجزاء لها, and it's a reward connected to it. For example, I say to you, if you study and you learn and you put your time in and you guys go home and you revise the notes and everything, I'm telling you guys, إِذَن تَنْجَحَ, then you will be, you'll pass the test. The إِذَن here now is a جَوَابًا وَجَزَاءً. It's a response to the what? For example, you say, سَأَجْتَهِدُ. Wallah, I'm going to strive. I look at you and say, إِذَن تَنْجَحَ, then you'll pass. Does that make sense? So إِذَن is used. There are three conditions mentioned for إذن, for it to do the what? The نصب الفعل المضارع. We'll come to that inshallah ta'ala in the متممة الأجرومية. The fourth one, which is the last one, is K. Are you with me, brothers? It's what? K. K means... in English, what's the best word for it? Yeah? Huh? In order to.
So that.
In order to. So that. All of those meanings. Yeah, it seems like that. But there's a babit. Babit meaning if this doesn't this doesn't happen, the K doesn't do its job properly. It won't work. And it's not the K that we're talking about here. The babit for it is antataqaddamaha. It has to go before it. Lam. Has to go before it. It either has to go before it lafadan or taqdiran. It has to be explicit or implicit, but it has to go before it. For example, if you say جِئْتُ كَيْ أَقْرَأَ الْعِلْمَ, I came in order to read knowledge. Can I say لِكَيْ أَقْرَأَ الْعِلْمَ? Ha. So, yeah, you could. صحيح, this is what we're talking about. Both of those, the first one is implicit, and the second one is explicit. What's the Are you with me? What is it? Is that whenever the lamb can enter it if I wanted to, and I can drop it if I want to. It's my choice. But if it won't accept it, then it's not the lamb that lamb okay we're talking about. We're not talking about the king that we're talking about. Now that we've spoken about nawasib fi'il mudari' bi nafsiha, we're now going to move on to the ones that do the fi'il mudari' with an mudmarah. They don't do it directly, but it's within itself. They do it with an mudmarah. And there are two types of those, which is jawazan and wujuban. Jawazan meaning it's permissible for it to do it. It's allowed for it to do it. It doesn't have to. And the second one, which is wujuban, it has to do it. There's no other way. The only one that's allowed to do it is lam ta'lil, the lam that enters the word that we just said before. Jitu li kay aqra al ilma. You can say jitu li aqra al ilma. It takes the same job as the word kay. Kay here is ta'lil, right? Reasoning, which you guys said what? So that or what? The lam here is the same. It's lam ta'lil. It's lam ta'lil. Also is called lamu kay. So that one, it's allowed, it's for it to be. The second one is the one that's wajib. And the ones that are wajib is five. Lamu juhud, hatta, fa'u sababiyya, wa'u al-ba'iyya, and the word aw. Those five are nawasib fi'il mudari'i bi'ad mudmara wujuban. It's wajib for it. So the first one is lamul juhud. Lamul juhud is what? Inkaru shadid. It's the lamb of rejection. Severe rejection. For example, ma kana Muhammadun liyal'aba. Muhammad is not one to play. No, he's not going to play basically. Wa lam yakun Mahmudun liyafhama ad-darsa. And Mahmud was not one who's able to understand the lesson. Hatta is also, and the condition for the hatta, for it to be a nasb, is it has to show toward, it has to show the word ila, or it has to be the ma'al ta'lil, which is the lamu ta'lil, the meaning that was in it. Are you with me? Or the lamu kay, the meaning that was in it has to be in it. One of those two, then it's allowed. For example, hatta yarji'a ilayna Musa. حتى يرجع إلينا موسى إلى أن يرجع إلينا موسى. That's what it means. إلى أن يرجع إلينا موسى. Until Musa comes to us. ولام التعليل. لام التعليل, which is the lamb of reasoning. For example, what would you say? اجتهد, strive. حتى تفوز. Strive so that you can pass the test. Then the author, the next one is fa, ha fa and the waw. The fa al-sababiyya. Or the waw al-sababiyya. Are you with me? No, fa al-sababiyya, sorry. And the waw al-ma'iyya. Fa al-sababiyya and the waw al-ma'iyya. The fa al-sababiyya is the fa of reason. Reasoning. So, for example, you say ما تأتينا فتحدثنا. You can also say وتحدثنا. They take the same meaning. What ما تأتينا? You're not coming to us. فتحدثنا, to talk to us. The واو السببية المعية. And the use of the word أو. جوازم الفعل المضارعي are 18 that the author mentioned. And they're divided into two. Okay? Some of them only do jazm of only one verb. And the other one, yajzimu fi'layni. It does two verbs. So, yajzimu fi'lan wahidan. It only does jazm of one verb. And the second one is yajzimu fi'layni. It does jazm of what? Two verbs. So, let's mention the ones that do jazm of two verbs, and the remaining is what does jazm of one fi'l. Are you with me, brothers? Yajzimu fi'layni is what? Four. In bittifaq nuhat. The grammarians all agree on this one. There's no khilaf that it does jazm of two verbs, the in. Then idma, This is according to the strongest of the opinions. There's a khilaf here. مهما okay is الصح the strongest of the opinions, and the remaining are فعلين two فعل. So the remaining we mean here is أي المتى أيان أين أن حيثما كيفما all of those are is يجزم فعلين and they are agreed upon consensus اتفاق هيا and the ones that do فعل واحد is لم ولما وألم وألما ولام الأمر ولام الدعاء ولام الناهية ولام الدعائية which is also known as لام الناهية those are the ones those six they do فعل واحد we're now going to start the last chapter which is باب مرفوعات الأسماء إن شاء الله تعالى we'll take another break